how mercury has to be filled into a mechaloid gauge. Here you see a mechaloid gauge with a reservoir, a capillary tube, scale, second reservoir, guide tube, and a marking to show the position where the capillary is sealed. Now, to start with, there are two locking bolts provided at the back. A locking nut is provided. When you have to fill mercury, you have to ensure that you are parallel to the logo, the scale is at the top, gradually tilt it in such a way that the gauge number is seen at the top. Rotate it, hold it in this place, insert the funnel, tilt it. There is a cap provided, remove the cap, gradually add mercury inside. Every time you add it, you have to slightly tap it or just slightly lift the funnel. Do not fill the volume together, gradually add the mercury inside. Once the complete volume has been filled inside, place your finger, rotate the gauge. In this position you would see mercury filled into the main reservoir. Connect the vacuum in the same position, keep the nut locked. Now we are going to demonstrate how the tube has to be inserted onto the nipple. Always ensure that the left hand is supporting the gauge. Rotate it in such a way that it at least climbs a single serration. Connected, loose the nut, start the vacuum. Rotate the gauge. Mechaloid gauge is a rotating gauge. You have to gradually tilt it. Here you would see the mercury rising into the guide tube. Gradually it will fill into the capillary. You have to take two readings. Kindly ensure that the mercury level does not cross the reference line. Rotate it. It is not mandatory that it needs to be parallelly straight. What would happen if you try to rotate it parallelly? Mercury would climb into the guide tube. You have to align it in such a way that it is parallel. Whatever reading is available, say example it is 0.5, is the vacuum which is achieved. Gradually tilt it to the desired level. We are demonstrating how mechaloid gauge has to be tested at ELC. Start with switching off the pump. Keep it in the original position. Rotate the tube, pull the nut, rotate the tube. There is a possibility of slight vacuum jerk. Here it is detached. When you want to remove the mercury, when you do not need to test the gauge, tilt it, connect the bottle, gradually remove the mercury back. Only do this if you have the experience to do it. Otherwise, there is a possibility that the quantity could spill out. Here you see it is being filled into the bottle. Tap it so that it does not stick, and you are able to remove the complete volume which has been filled. Just lock it. Mercury has been removed, the gauge is placed, tilt it and bring it to position 0. Once it is done, insert the cap. See, the complete system is done. Here you see two more gauges which are again mechaloid.